bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Yeah. Hey, hey. She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom. I'm sorry.
He said he only love his bed and his mama. Can y'all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me go back to What you laughing at me?
You?
They only love my bed and my mama. All right, all right, all right. I don't know why I'm stealing. Kevin Hart gonna get me for copyright infringement. I should know better, being the businesswoman that I am. He probably does have it. He may have it copyrighted. If not, I'm gonna keep using it. All right, all right, all right. Okay, y'all. Today, what are we talking about? The three benefits of being what? An entrepreneur, or the three benefits of entrepreneurship. It's all the same thing. It's just a play on words. Brought to you live and direct by Flea, FLEA. Not the bug, but I'm going to bug you with some real estate. I'm sorry. It could be real estate. I'm going to bug you and give you some advice you can bank on. Flea, Financial Literacy Educators of America. Here we go. Three benefits of being an entrepreneur. I probably have more than three, but there are three top benefits. If you're interested in becoming an entrepreneur, I guarantee you may already know these, because these are the reasons why you're probably interested in becoming one. So Bootzilla,
what would be
your top reason that you became an entrepreneur?
What is an entrepreneur?
Oh, me? Someone that finds a need and fulfills it. Why do you need to find a need? So that what? Your product or your service can be purchased. They're not going to purchase it unless they need it. That's straight off the dome. That's not from Webster. That's not from a book. That's not from Google. That's from Trevelyan book. Yeah. Complete on Trevelyan. That's from the book of Trevelyan. Straight from Paris.
Oh, okay. Jesus.
All right, so some people call it today, they don't call them entrepreneurs. Some, shall I say the new generation, they call them bosses. I'm gonna be a boss, I'm gonna go get the bag, I'm a boss.
Oh, that's what, okay.
And I'm gonna tell you how that's kind of asinine, because you would prefer to be a leader versus a boss. That's another topic. So there's a lot of, what would you call it, slang terms that are used today that don't align with the true meaning of an entrepreneur, an investor, a wealth building constitutes. So boys and girls, when you say I want to be a boss, that is not what you really want to be. You don't want to be a boss. You want to be a leader. There's a big difference, and maybe we'll do that in another session. I'll write that down. What's the difference between a boss versus a leader? There's so much to educate you guys on, but if you sign up with DFW Flea, $30 a month, you get everything in and out. I'll just give you tidbits, but I can go more in detail when you sign up with the courses, and you'll participate in our Super Saturdays, where you actually receive me live and direct through Flea, Capri, Monique, Trevelyan, through Flea, teach you more. And you will get this personality too. Trust and believe, you're getting the whole package. All right, let's go. So did I answer your question?
Yes, ma'am.
Probably wasn't prepared for me to say it like that, but that's what it is. It's a person that identifies a need and fulfills the need. Now, let me say that in layman's terms. Find something to sell or something some people need to solve a solution, to have a solution to a problem, okay? Layman's term, again, don't judge me on grammar. Find something that people, dogs, animals, anybody have a problem, and you fulfill that, you give them solution to their problem. That's finding a need. They need what you got. Okay, can I go back to being educated now?
Yeah.
Okay, so you find a need and you fulfill it, but you do it for a fee. That's really what an entrepreneur is. Not a boss, it's an entrepreneur. It's a leader. Okay, I'm not going to go into what the difference is. So, what was your number one reason for becoming an entrepreneur?
Are you talking to me?
Yes, ma'am. Let me see if there's anybody in here listening to us. Yes, ma'am.
Well, my number one reason is because of how I was raised. And I dreamt of becoming a business owner.
Wow.
And I wanted to be autonomous.
For those that don't know, that I may not be.
I know. autonomy.
Cater to all audiences.
Self-control in my own destiny. And I wanted, you just wanted one?
Just one. We're going to do one. That's how we have to chunk the information for all of my educators out there. I see we have Mr. Crystal Marie. She knows what chunking is. She's an educator. So we need to chunk the lesson. We only have 30 minutes, so let's go.
Did I answer it?
You said your number one reason was to have autonomy?
Well, yeah. And I didn't like taking orders from nobody.
So to be a boss.
I wanted to control. No, I don't want to be a boss. I wanted to create my own legacy, destiny.
So if I was to sum that up, then it would be to be for wealth building, to have unlimited earning potential, income.
Well, that's one of the reasons.
Okay, one reason. So your reason would be unlimited income potential, which will provide you an opportunity to do what you want to do when you want to do. We're going to speak layman's terms for everybody out there. Today, we're going to speak in layman's terms. Meaning, 7 Mile. Lead better. Everybody knows what that is. We're going to talk on Luke 12 or either 7 Mile today. So she decided, and myself, decided to, one, become an entrepreneur or become a leader, fulfill a need, and get paid for it because we have unlimited earning potential. So the first thing is dealing with money, of course, because we all go into business wanting to start our own business for several reasons. But the main thing is to make more money. And when you think of making more money, there's unlimited earning potential, meaning just like the Bible says, you're going to be whatever seeds you plant, certain it's going to come to harvest. If you don't get out of the bed and you don't put in the work for your own business, because remember, you don't have a boss telling you what to do, when to do, and how to do it, and what expectations to meet. You don't have a boss when you become an entrepreneur. So that means unlimited earning potential. You can make as much as you want. For example, my educators. Yep. Educators. I'm speaking to you guys out there. If any of you are on here, feel free to comment or ask to be brought on. But all of my educators out there, you can attest to this, and you can probably do a praise dance real quick. You are underpaid. You do not have unlimited earning potential. I don't care how many letters you have behind your name or in front of your name, doctor, M.E.D., or whatever, M.B.A., whatever the case may be. You're only going to get that salary that they designated to pay you, no matter how many hours you stay at that school. After school curriculums, how many you bring in work home, you're grading papers. You're literally probably working 12 to 13 hours a day. So you are not going to get unlimited earning potential. Even when you do go back to school and you get in debt for $50,000 more to get the doctorate degree, where you could have taken, let me put a disclaimer out there. I could have one if I wanted it, but I did not find it economically advantageous for me to invest into a doctorate degree. And let me explain to you why. I have a master's, an MBA. I was going back to school to get a doctorate in business. However, when I looked at how much it cost, $50,000 to $60,000 for what? I make more than that now, like triple.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, triple, right. Quadruple. Mm-hmm. So I would get in debt, pay interest, all these people, all this money, for what? Recognition? For someone to call me doctor? I'm a doctor in my own right. I'm a philosopher in my own right. Let my son tell it, he say, Mom, you a doctor in what you do because you mastered it. You're not, that master's degree don't mean it. You've exceeded a master's degree. He said, you a beast. That's what they need to create a degree called beast. That's what my baby
That's right.
Did. And I told him, no, I'm an eagle. They need to create a degree for called eagles. We fly above the rest and we soar. We don't actually intertwine with others because we fly so high. We don't even get caught up in, I don't want to be too perverted, but we have sex in the air.
Negativity.
We have sex in the air. I mean, we would never
cohabitate
with anything less than us. Eagles will never have a mixed breed because they don't. The chickens can't fly out there. Even the hawks can't get up there. But let's get back to it. You're underpaid. You will never have any more than the 60. I got paid, what was it, $65,000 to be a math teacher. No matter how many hours I work, tutoring, what do you call it? Extracurricular activities, which I did not participate in. I was a little different. I was like the, was Angela. But my main thing was unlimited earning potential. Boom, that's the number one. For example, being a real estate broker, when I get out and network or make phone calls or hustle, I make more money.
That's right.
Simple as that. I eat what I kill. Same thing as being an entrepreneur. That's why I tell you guys, you don't want to be a boss. Boss right. tells you what to do. Boss mm-hmm. gives you, what you call that, an outline. Have expectations.
That's right.
Deadlines. You don't want that. You can be your own, what do you call that? Help me out.
You got to think outside the box.
You're going to create your own destiny.
Create your own destiny.
The second reason, first dealing with money. The second reason is, I can say, to make your own hours. I'm a single lady. Okay, Beyonce, I'm going to have a little disclaimer. Don't sue me. I know she probably going to hate on me because I'm naturally fine. You know, she had to bow.
Oh, my God.
I still love you, baby girl. But anyway, to make your own hours, it's nothing better than, I could say, doing what you want to do, which is part two of yours.
Exactly.
Doing what you want to do when you would like to do it.
That's right.
State. Now I'm going to be 7 Mile. I'm going to be Ledbetter. I'm going to tell it like the T.I. is. Doing what the hell you want to do when you want to. Nobody can boss you around. That's why it's not a good fit. Making your own hours is definitely valuable. Definitely for all of my single mothers.
Right.
That is crucial. I raised my son as an entrepreneur. When I was an entrepreneur, I never missed a basketball game. I never missed picking him up. All of my meetings were scheduled around him because he was my priority, family first. Well, God first, then family. So being an entrepreneur positioned me to be able to invest in my son so that I can get the fruits of my labor, which is what I received from him now, being the man that he is now that I'm very, very proud of. So you definitely want to position yourself where you can make your own hours so you can then have unlimited earning potential. So it goes hand in hand. If you can have your own hours, meaning you can create more money because you dictate when your meetings are held. You may say, I'm going to go a good 30, 40 days strong, grinding, make me about a good $250,000. I'm a vacation for the rest of the year. You can do that.
That's right.
You're an entrepreneur. So first reason is, I'm sorry, the first benefit is unlimited moolah. What's the blend term for moolah? Cheddar?
Yeah.
Cheddar. Get you some more cheddar. Yeah. Unlimited earning potential. The second, in my opinion, is make your own hours. What do you guys think the number three reason is? Wild guess. If you had to guess, what do you think it is?
You're asking the audience.
Yeah, audience. What do you think the top three reasons for being an entrepreneur is? Anybody want to guess? I'm going to give you about 10, 9, 8, 6, I should create a song, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nobody knows. I know y'all know. I got some doctors on here. I got some dispensary owners on here. What do you do, Steve Martin? Are you the Steve Martin from the television show? I got some ballers on here. So I know you guys know. Now, the dispensary owners, I know for sure this is not their number three reason. I know they don't indulge in this type of activity, even though it is legal.
Right.
But the number three reason is to focus on your passion.
Right.
Your passion.
Yes, yes.
Why do you think that will be the number three reason? Bootzilla.
Because if you love what you do, you will be very successful at it.
Booyah!
If you are gifted of God, because entrepreneurs are gifted.
Yes, we
Everybody can't be an entrepreneur. because they don't have the gifts. Now, we all have gifts, mm-hmm. but you got to have a passion for people, for your employers, the people who work with you, the community.
Yep.
And if you work that passion and give it all to God and do what he say do, you will be blessed beyond measure.
Amen.
Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over.
Oh, overflow. That's what I call it. An overflow. And I'm not talking about this in senior water either. Overflow of blessings.
That's right.
Thank you, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That is true. Dr. Trevelyan, she says write-offs. Yes, it is. That's one of my favorite things. Tax write-offs. That's one of the other benefits. That's probably, remember I said I had more than three?
Yeah, that's you're going to have more. Yeah.
Tax write-offs is definitely one. Maybe I should have said top five because there's so many, you guys.
There are a lot of them.
There's a lot of them. If you want to learn more, then you know what you need to do. Oh, yeah. Sign up with DFW Fleet.
Exactly.
You can learn way more than just the top three. I can show you how to become one, what it takes to get incorporated, how to get your EIN, how to do all this stuff that you see me doing. You see this banner? I created all of this stuff, this marketing material.
That's right.
I show you. Now I am pouring on with my blessings. I'm what do you call it? Paying it forward, but you guys are going to pay for it.
Yeah.
You're going to get it free. So $1 a day. Are you willing to invest into yourself so that you become what? An entrepreneur, have this unlimited earning potential, be able to
that's
make
the
your
whole key.
Hours, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And focus on your passion. Mm-hmm. I am focusing on my passion. That's why I am bubbly right now. That's why I'm happy. This is not a forced Zoom that my boss told me to get on and facilitate. No. Trust and believe. If I had someone here that worked at the school with me, they would say this is not the same Capri that we see with ours. No, because that wasn't my passion. My passion, and you know, is business development, financial literacy, and real estate. FLEA, and all of those fall under that jurisdiction of financial literacy. That's my passion. I love it.
Exactly.
I wear this to the grocery store, and I still think I'm fine.
Oh, my God. Here. She's so silly.
So, again, our top three benefits of being an entrepreneur. I'm going to throw that fourth one in there for Dr. T. That's what they call her. That's what was on her Cadillac, wasn't it? Dr. T. She has a passion for teaching. I'm going to turn her into an entrepreneur, but we have a teaching coaching program coming soon. I'm throwing all kind of little drops out there. But again, top three, one more time. Make your own hours. Do what you want to do when you want to do. That's what Boozilla said. Unlimited earning potential, so no one can tell you what to do and how to arrange on your neck. Focus on your passion. You get up every day willingly. That's why we have no problem working till 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning.
Or all night.
I wish Tez could tell it. I remember nights where he slept on the couch at Trevelyan Realty Group. Literally, it was not, I wasn't a bad parent. I was building a franchise. I was building a legacy.
Right.
That was part of my journey. And he was part of it. He was in the trenches. Baby, get your little butt on over there and go to sleep. And while he was asleep, I was creating and building my real estate franchise.
That's right.
He didn't miss a beat. He was with mama. He had nice, you know, we still had a bathroom for him to brush his teeth. He didn't get treated. It was no negligence there at all. But at the end of the day, I had a passion for what I was doing. Even now, Boosie would tell you. See, I look good right now, don't I?
Oh, stop.
Boosie would tell you, I had bags in my eyes not too long ago.
Yeah.
She called me and said, what is wrong with you? That last video you put out there, you don't look yourself. You all right there and there? And I was like, yeah, I'm fine. Well, what's wrong with you? Nothing. To me, it was nothing.
No. Sleep.
I had no problem with staying up all night.
Yeah.
I crashed eventually, but when you have a passion for what you do, you will invest in it and you will strive. You won't give up. That's never, ever. Never give up.
Never.
The goals and don't let anybody stop you. Anybody. No. Nobody. What's your scripture for today, Boozilla?
I got a whole bunch of them, but
got Pastor Trevelyan on here, Pastor T on here.
Let's do okay, this is what you're saying. Proverbs 10, I can't see, I think that's 4 or 5. It say lazy hands make for poverty. Diligent hands make wealth. That's what you said again.
Proverbs what?
I can't see it. It's 10, I think. I've whited it out. I give
Proverbs
it to you.
Proverbs
10? Yeah, it's 10.
And what is it again? Lazy hands. Say it one more time.
Lazy hands make for poverty, and diligent hands bring wealth. That's exactly what you're saying. You get up, you believe in what you're doing, you have a gift, you act upon it. Faith without works is dead.
And you want to know the 7 mile thing? If you don't work, you don't eat.
You don't eat.
You don't work.
It's all in the Bible.
And that is biblical. So while y'all lazy men out there, you better get your butts up and go do something. Don't think us women, oh, she all about the money. Yeah, we got bills to pay. It's in the Bible. It's one of those movies too. They did that. But you don't work, you don't eat. Proverbs 10. Mm-hmm. Look it up. That's our scripture. I want to show a little promotion for you guys. Again, Flea, you can get way more than what I'm giving you. I'm giving you a little tidbits, 30 minutes every Wednesday, but I have so much more to offer. So, so much more. But again, we're going to be doing this forever. I just give you a tidbit of how deep my mind is.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. I know. I'm crazy. I'm going to share my screen for you guys. Let me see.
Okay.
I want you guys to see the production over here. Can you guys see it? Play it one more time for you. One more time. You ready? One more time. My promotion for today. I'm going to make sure you turn it off. There we go. Can y'all hear me now? Can you hear
me? Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Sound like that lady, a guy from Sprint. All right, you guys, that's our topic for today, Wealth Wednesday from FLEE, Financial Literacy. Oh, I gotta clean my hat off. Financial Literacy Educators of America, bringing you advice you can bank on Wealth Wednesday. Today's topic, one more time, was top three benefits of entrepreneurship. Recap, make your own hours. Unlimited earning potential. And you can focus on your passion. Again, if you want more from an extended version, make sure you sign up at dfwflee.org. Remember, it's a 501c3 charitable organization. 501c charitable organization, tax exempt. We legit over here. So these are 11 units. Make sure you sign up if you want more extensive information. But next week, what are we going over next week, Boosie?
Entrepreneurship, you're not finished, right?
Yes, next you did another extension of entrepreneurship, the mindset.
Pros and cons.
Huh?
Pros and cons.
Oh, yeah. So next week is the disadvantages of entrepreneurship. Right. There's pros and cons with everything. Like everybody right. always, oh, I want a man. Oh, there's pros and cons with that too. But again, let me calm down.
But there's so much more to what you're doing.
They're going to have to learn the rest through
DFW. I know. I already know.
Oh. That's I'm an entrepreneur. I'm fulfilling the need.
But I understand that.
Okay, you guys. We did it on time today. 6:59. We out of here. This is the first time we got out of 30 minutes. I know y'all love it. So looking forward to seeing you guys next week. Again, please, 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 if you have any children, preferably 9 through 12 in high school, upperclassmen, anyone that you think your children, nieces, nephews, friends of a friend, congregation, please share the video. Please share the Wealth Wednesday's upcoming videos. Please share the information in reference to FLEA. The more the merrier, the more people I can help, the happier I'll be. Again, if you don't work, you don't eat. So this is my work, giving back to you, advice you can bank on. I'll see you next week. Love you.